Hello everyone. In this video, we will learn how to draw a hypocycloid. Let's understand what epicycloid and hypocycloid exactly mean. Consider this circle or a circular path. If a circle rolls along this circular path such that it completes one revolution, the path traced by a point on the circumference of the rolling circle is called the epicycloid. Similarly, if a circle rolls one complete revolution on the inner side of the circle's path, as shown, the path traced by a point on the circumference of the rolling circle is called the hypocycloid. The procedures to construct these two are similar, with small changes. In this video, let's understand how to draw a hypocycloid. To do so, we will consider an example question. A circle of 50 mm diameter rolls on the inner side of the circumference of another circle of 150 mm diameter. Trace the locus of a point on the circumference of the rolling circle for one complete revolution. Also, draw the normal and tangent to the curve at 40 mm from the center of the directing circle. Let's begin drawing. The question says a circle of 50 mm diameter rolls on the inner side of the circumference of another circle of 150 mm. Therefore, we first need to draw the arc of the bigger circle inside which the smaller circle is rolling. To get the exact length of the arc required for the smaller circle to roll for one complete revolution, we need to find this angle. This angle is given as theta equals ratio of the radius of the rolling circle to the radius of the bigger circle, multiplied by 360 degrees. Therefore, the angle made will be 120 degrees. So, we have the angle made by the arc equal to 120 degrees. Using this, we can draw the arc of the bigger circle inside which the smaller circle rolls. Take a ruler and draw the horizontal line as shown. Using a protractor, mark the angle of 120 degrees and draw the line as shown. Next, take a compass and adjust it to 75 mm in length. Since the diameter of the bigger circle is given as 150 mm, and using this point O as the center, draw the arc as shown. Therefore, we have the required arc. After this, we will draw a circle of 50 mm diameter. To do so, take a compass and adjust it to 25 mm in length since the diameter of the rolling circle is 50 mm. Keep the compass at this point and mark the line as shown. This point will act as the center required to construct the smaller circle. After this, using this point as the center, draw the circle as shown. Now, consider a point P at this location. When the circle revolves inside along the circumference of the larger circle, point P will follow a path, which we need to trace. Let's divide this circle into 8 parts using a protractor. After this, using a compass, draw arcs from each point using point O as the center. Next, we will divide this 120 degree angle into 8 equal parts. You can either divide the angle, 120 degrees, by 8, which will give 15 degrees, and mark 15 degrees using a protractor, or you can divide the angle using a compass. To divide with a compass, take the compass and adjust it to a suitable length. Using the central point as the center, draw an arc as shown. Then, using the 2 points where the arc intersects as centers, cut the arc as shown. Using these 2 points, draw a line as shown, to divide the angle in half. Similarly, using these new points as centers, cut arcs again as shown. Using these 2 points as references, draw a line up to the central point to further divide the angle. Repeat this process to divide the angle into 8 equal parts. Thank you. Next, label these points as C1, C2, C3, and so on, up to C8. Therefore, we now have the required construction lines for tracing the locus of point P. We can observe that when the rolling circle rolls to point C1, point P moves along this line. To mark this, take a compass, adjust it to the radius of the smaller circle, and using point C1 as the center, cut an arc on this line. Similarly, when the circle rolls to point C2, point P moves along this line. Using point C2 as the center, cut an arc on this line as shown. Repeat this process for the other points. In the end, join all these points with a smooth curve. This is the required hypocycloid. In the end, we need to draw a normal and a tangent at 0.40 mm distance from the center of the directing circle. Here this circle is the directing circle. We need to draw a normal and tangent to a curve at a 0.40 mm distance from the center. To do so, take a compass, adjust it to 40 mm distance as shown, and using this center point O as a center, cut the arc on the curve. Label this point as K. After this, adjust the compass to the radius of the rolling circle as shown, and using this point K as the center, cut the arc on this center line as shown. Label this point as N. Next, using center point O and N, draw a line up to the circumference of the directing circle. This point will be our point M. After this, from point M, draw a line joining to point K. This line will be our normal line. In the end, using protractor, draw a line which perpendicular to this normal line at point K. Therefore, this is our tangent line. Therefore, we have the required hypocycloid and the normal and the tangent. I hope this video helped you understand how to draw the hypocycloid of a circle. If you like my videos and want to learn more, you can check out for the link in the description for the complete engineering drawing. If you are new to my channel, subscribe to my channel and turn on the notifications to get all my latest video.